All right, up here at the top left, member of the team NS Hosa, named after a Protoss hero. He is
NS Hosa, Tesseract.
NS Hosa, Tassadar. Down here at the bottom right, a member of the team Zenex. You're gonna have to try hard to solve this one because
Zenex,
he is.
Botched.
Totally botched that. Alright, so this is a PvP finals. This is kind of like the Conclave fighting against the people who went to Shakuris back in the Brood War story. You know, some people think that it's okay to talk to the Dark Templar. Some people do not. They get mad. You come back to Ire, and there's this army waiting for you.
They get mad and just forget you.
Yeah, you can get forgated by the Conclave. Tassadar was actually kind of the ambassador to Shakuris, so we'll see if he goes DTs. I doubt he will. Jokes aside, though, the reason why we said earlier that this map is so Forgate heavy is because there's only one ramp. It's a wide open ramp, and then there's no real area to defend against Stalkers. Once the warping occurs, if you use sentries, they're not really going to be able to block anything. You need two sentries to really block off the choke point, and if you make two sentries, that's so many less units, and all you have to do is bait out the force fields and then go in. So you'd be crazy not to Forgate on this map. People have gotten away with other builds, but it's very difficult to do so.
Yeah, especially against a player like Tassadar, who does like his aggressive style anyway. But it's really going to come down to, if he does do it again, Puzzle really needs to find that probe.
Yeah, he does. The thing about, if you're not going to Forgate, you check a little bit for the pylon with your first four units, or at least you should. And then after that, you stay inside your base, because if you get caught, like we saw last game with your first Stalker, then it's very difficult to hold the ramp. The probe gets up there. It's really nasty. So right off the bat, we see Puzzle actually looking like he wants to go for the three Stalker rush.
Yeah.
Which means he wants to deter any Forgates, but it's still very difficult to do that on a map of this size. You have to find the probe, and the probe could be anywhere.
Yeah, it's such a large map. There's a lot of avenues where that probe can stick that pylon and just be out of the way. Even if they put it on the bottom of the ramp there and just put the probe vision at the top, they can warp in through there. There's just so many different spots you can find. But I do like how Puzzle's going for this three Stalker rush. It's at least deterring something.
Exactly. And Tassadar is going to Forgate. He's going to add that fourth one right now. So doing the exact same build order as last game. 12 gate into Forgate, making his gates a 24 supply. And Tassadar already has his first, or Puzzle rather, already has his first Stalker out. He's getting those second two coming over here, but the probe is going to start a pylon. We'll get a shot of it in a second. Pretty far away from those Stalkers, and even that pylon might be enough to warp.
Well, I think he just wants to be really safe. Doesn't want to lose that probe this early, because you expect this kind of thing on this map.
And here comes the probe. Well, there's a hidden probe for a Puzzle, but here comes the probe of Tassadar up the ramp. He hasn't made the pylon yet.
Nice timing on the other two Stalkers as they come through. He sees what's going on, is going to be able to micro this very well, and he is about 20 seconds behind on the warp gate research, though. A chrono boost going down on Tassadar yet again. He's going to pick off this extra Stalker, but is he going to be able to get these pylons down in time, Wolf?
He won't be able to get both of the pylons. He will be able to maybe get the one on the left, but Tassadar is just going to use the one on the right instead. He cancels that pylon.
Good choice there. He really needs to get that probe, though.
Uh-oh. Here they come, the first four Stalkers. Right on top of the Stalkers, a Puzzle. Puzzle has to back away here. Back in Puzzle's base, his warp gate has finished as well. He did go up to four gates. It's going to come down to micro here.
Well, he's going to have the Stalker count as well, unless he loses that pylon. Nice control by Puzzle on that one Stalker. He just needs to drive this back. His warp gate research, of course, is lower. And he's going to be behind on the warp ins, and it's really kind of going to count down to control, like you're saying.
Good control by Puzzle. It's five Stalkers in Puzzle's favor now, but Zealots and one more Stalker being warped in for Tassadar. Remember, it's better to engage on the inside of the choke point or on the outside of it because you have a better concave.
Yeah, and he is a little bit behind on the warp-in rounds as well, so he has that 5-6 seconds where he needs to be really careful. He's got an extra Zealot, though, but he still is even... No, he's actually one down on the Stalker count. He needs to be really careful here.
Needs to make sure he keeps that Stalker count high because that's so important. And uh-oh, his Zealots are going to fall very quickly here. Tassadar might take a very early lead.
He's losing a lot of those Zealots, but Puzzle doing some great control here, trying to take down all these Stalkers. More Zealots, another Stalker being warped in. He is still down on the units here, though. And
Yeah, Puzzle, it looks like he is in a lot of trouble. The Zealots are going to do work on these probes.
He's trying to warp in more another Zealot to try and deal with these as well, but he's just, he's always that one round behind.
And Tassadar now having, of course, the better Stalker count. He's got so many Zealots here to tank as well. And basically what it's going to come down to is Puzzle's going to have to make something decisive happen here, or he is just going to lose. Better Stalker count is going to be very important. Yeah. Sorry,
he needs to focus down those Stalkers. He's going for the Zealots. Really needs to get that Stalker count down.
I'm like stuttering over my words here. Everything is happening at once, man. Tassadar trying to take out that pylon. He's not able to, though.
Does pick off one extra Stalker. I'm really surprised he's not focusing down these Stalkers here for Tassadar. There we go. He's going to get one, catching himself behind his own Zealots. He is that one Stalker up in here.
Yeah, this is looking pretty good for Tassadar, simply because he's got better control here, I think. But he does, of course, get backed away. When you have that lower Stalker number, you just have to back up, at least temporarily.
Trying to chase down that Zealot. There we go. Does pick it off just in time. He's got those extra Stalkers now, though, forcing Tassadar to pull back. He needs to move that Stalker back, though, running into the Zealots.
Yeah, those Stalkers taking a lot of unnecessary damage at this point. Puzzle just falling further and further behind. Yeah, and the Zealots chasing the Stalkers all the way back, allowing Tassadar to come in here. He's going to take out this pylon.
He did have a little bit of a window of opportunity there, but just didn't focus down the Stalkers as well as he could have.
And the probes here for Puzzle having to be pulled in such a way that they avoid damage. Losing some of those probes. Nice micro, though, by Puzzle. He's actually evened up the supply count. His Stalkers chasing back the Stalkers of Tassadar, at least temporarily here, as he warps in more units. Very, very tense game.
It's very close as well, 25 to 31, even on the Stalker count as well. It's just those extra Zealots.
Yeah, the extra Zealots.
If Puzzle can just avoid them and pick off the Stalkers, he should be in a lot better spot.
Yeah, this might be it. In fact, he's going to be able to target down these Stalkers now. The Zealots just doing too much tanking and...
No, the warped in Stalker getting a lot of damage done on it as well. The Zealots now just chasing down the Stalkers yet again. Stalker's going for the probes. I like this split by Tassadar, splitting up his attention between the probes and those Stalkers.
Yeah, doing a lot of damage to the shields of those Stalkers, picking off probes where he can. And now Tassadar just has more probes. He's got better units. And he's going to target down these Stalkers most likely. Remember, he doesn't want to get too close to that probe line because then the Stalkers can be surrounded by probes.
He needs to be careful.
It's just so hard to micro these three different groups at once, and Puzzle just can't keep up with everything with the Zealots in there.
Yeah, the Stalkers are on a lot of health. He's actually got stuck in between that Zealot, but luckily his own Zealot tanks a lot of the fire there, chasing these units down now.
Nice control. Snipes that one Stalker. There's only one Stalker left for Puzzle, and when that one falls, I think that's going to be game.
Yeah.
And it will indeed fall. Nice control by Tassadar. And Puzzle just can't do anything else. GG! That was a tense game. I need to let you talk more, man. I'm just like, whoa. Too many things going on at once. I was actually like trying to micro my words when I was watching those Stalkers. I played so many PvP yesterday. I probably played 20 PvPs yesterday.
Yeah.
Just coincidentally on the ladder. And
the one thing that stands out in my mind as I watched that game, though, is the one thing that stood out. When Puzzle was retreating his Stalkers, he would always seem to A-move back and attack the Zealots. Whereas Tassadar did it, and he was always hitting Stalkers.
Yeah, he kept those shields down, kept doing the damage, and I can't stress to you guys enough how important that Stalker count is, but then, what was really interesting about Tassadar's play was he warped in some Zealots intentionally.
Yeah.
It wasn't just, oh, I don't have enough money. Then he sent the Zealot, like, one Zealot to the mineral line.
Yeah.
Then he, like, targeted one Zealot on each Stalker.
Yep.
And then Puzzle was like, oh, I'm down a little bit. I've got to micro this better, but I can't because there's always a Zealot following every Stalker. Every time I want to shoot, I'm taking Zealot damage.
Yep. And he did react appropriately. He just didn't have the micro to be able to keep up with it. He was down like that one warp in, which is critical in that because he'd have the same unit count for about 5 seconds, and then Tassadar would have more.
Tassadar did a great job of reacting when he saw the three Stalker rush coming out, so he immediately dropped those pylons. Because if you don't get those pylons up, then you can't make it happen. Then he eventually brought... I don't know if he kept that probe alive or what, but he always had the probe with his army as well, which does get kind of annoying, bugs out the AI a little bit. It also allowed him to, if he wanted to, warp in more pylons inside of his opponent's base, do whatever he wanted. Always kept a probe with his army, and just, I think, controlled a little bit better his timing, though. Like you kept saying, he was just one round ahead, and that's just so hard to deal with.
Because every time Puzzle felt like he was getting back in it, four more units would walk into his main, and he's like, ah. Oh.
Yeah. Can't
Not the
you guys
best feeling.
How important it is the timing of that attack. When the four Stalkers are there and you have then five Stalkers and your opponent's warping in Stalkers,
yeah,
then those Stalkers are taking damage while they warp in, and then like he barely holds it off, and it's like six Stalkers or five Stalkers against like two, and then he tries to warp in to even up the count, then he warps in more, and you're like, oh no!
It's a lot less even than it actually looks just because of that warp gate timing.
Just one Stalker difference makes all the difference in the world.
Yeah. Alright, so next map is going to be Crevasse by the looks of
it. Yeah, it is. It's actually one of the more interesting maps we have for PvP. It's got a wide ramp, but the ramp isn't exposed right off the bat. You can destroy the rocks very quickly. But we are going to take a 5-minute break, guys, when we get back. Game 3 on Crevasse. Right.